This is huge. Just looking around and seeing y'all. This is amazing. It's been an amazing day. It's been an amazing year since she came into our house on February 5th of last year. So we're 4 days shy of 1 year of her being with us. And just, it's been amazing. This past week and even this morning, one thing I feel like I keep hearing the Lord say, and I've just kind of been soaking it, is a verse from 1 John that says, "See with what great love the Father has loved us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are." Yeah. And so I just wanted to throw that out there, share that with all of you, that's what we are. We are children of God. Just see what great love the Father has for us, that we should be called children of God. And so we're all children, and we hope that this party is a space for you to connect with the kids and connect with the unicorns and be magical with the cupcakes and the muffins that believe in miracles and all that. But yeah, I wanted to share a couple things from our experience. It's great. Welcome. But yeah, so thank you all so much for being here. Thank you for being our village. Y'all are our village. You know, they say the phrase is, it takes a village to raise a child. And this is our village. Y'all are our village. So thank you so much for each one of you, the pivotal role that each and every one of you have played in this process of bringing her into our family. Like, she's in our family. It's a collective all. In Mark 9:36-37, it says, and he took, this is Jesus, it says, and he took a child and put him in the midst of them. And taking him in his arms, he said to them, "Whoever receives one such child in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but him who sent me." And so when Jesus is saying this, he's saying, you know, the person doing the good deed or doing the receiving is not the one representing God. It says the one who's being received. It's the one who's the child that is the representative of God. And this really hit home with me the first week that she came into our house. There was one night that I was putting her, I was trying to calm her down before bed, and emotions were high for everyone. And she was screaming, and just like in that moment, I was sitting there holding a 15-pound, 1.5-year-old with tubes coming out of her body. And I heard the Lord say, "Blake, she is the manifestation of my presence in your home." And just the weight of that, like, for me. And it just, if there was anything about, like, I'm representing God for her, I'm doing this good thing, I'm helping a child, me was just swept away. It was an honor to have her into our home and to welcome her into our family. Just absolutely amazing. The past year has been an incredible privilege to watch her. It's just been an honor to have her in our home. People often say when they hear you're going to do foster care that sounds really hard to get connected with the child and to get attached to them, but also be willing to let them go. And we've heard people say, "I can never do that." And I've said that before. I literally said that would be too hard. I can never do that. And even when you go through foster care training, they will tell you, "We are asking you to willingly allow yourself to be hurt. We're asking you to attach yourself to a child, bring them into your home, treat them as your own, but hold that relationship with an open hand, because the goal is reunification with the parents." So they ask you to willingly allow yourself to be hurt. And I found that if these children that need us, if they're the representative of Jesus, if by receiving them we receive Jesus, by entering their hurt, we enter his hurt. And when we enter his pain, we don't enter pain, we enter his joy. Because Jesus took all the pain for us. Jesus stepped in and took our pain. So when we go there with him, there's not pain to be had, there's joy to be had. And I can tell you through our experience on behalf of both of us, the joy that we've experienced through having her in our home has far exceeded any pain we felt, any hurt we've had, any suffering. Kind of like Paul says, the sufferings that we've experienced cannot even compare to the glory that is to be revealed. And just the glory of today, of adopting her, of making it final, of saying, "You're ours, you're stuck with us, you're ours forever, and we're going to be here all through it all." Just the glory of that has far exceeds anything. And yeah, it's just amazing. Yeah, so I wanted to share one thing about, so it, some of you have probably heard, we with the legal change of her and our family, we've actually changed her name. Her new name came from probably about 6-8 months ago. It was during one of the hardest parts of the case. It was very trying in a lot of different ways, and it looked like she was actually going to be going back. And there were some reservations about that, but the news was she was going back. And so preparing for that, and one morning I was praying for her, and I just felt the Lord speaking about his protection over her and his presence with her, kind of just like along those same lines of his presence with her. And I heard just a prophetic word from the Lord that it will be said of her that though she was broken, Paisley rose to her destiny. And in Jesus, and I feel like there's a huge destiny on her life. There's a huge calling on her life. And I heard that she rose to her destiny. It will be said of her that she rose to her destiny. And so I thought with that her name should be Paisley Rose Destiny. Even though it looks like she's going back, if she were to ever come into our family, we could change her name should be Paisley Rose Destiny Bearden. And so that is her new name as of 8:30 this morning. Decided we're going to call her Rosie, and so that's probably going to be an incredibly hard switch for some of you, because it is for me. I still call her Paisley every other time, but yeah, her name is Rosie, and she's actually done better with it than any of us. From like the first day we started calling her that, and we're like, Rosie, she's like, yes, I'm coming. She's done great with it. So yeah, that's her name. Yeah, and we stand with confidence on that word, that she will rise to her destiny. And we are just incredibly honored that at 8:30 this morning, we were legally given a ticket to a front row seat to watch her rise to her destiny in Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah, so we're so excited. We're so honored that she's a part of our family. And just one last thing I want to share is when we first started doing foster care, and we told people that we were going to do foster care, one thing that Gracie would always say is she said, we feel like we have room in our home and in our hearts for a child who needs a home and a family. And I just, like, I mean, y'all know her. She's amazing. She's an amazing woman. She's the reason why all of this. But she, in saying that, she just echoed the Father's heart so well. The Father heart of God, that I have room for you in my home and in my heart. And I just want to express that to each one of you. First, in two fronts. One, I want you to know that is what the Father is saying to you. That is the gospel. The Father is crying out to each one of us, saying, I have room for you in my home. I sent my Son to make that known to you, and he is with me preparing that home for you. I have room for you in my home, and I have room for you in my heart. You've had a place in my heart from before you ever existed, before time began. I knew you. I had dreams for you. And so I just want you to know how much you are loved by the Father in heaven, and how much Jesus loves you and coming to make that known to you. And the second way is I would just challenge you, if you may be in a position to foster, to ask yourself, do I have room in my home, in my heart? Because I'm not going to tell you statistics. You've probably heard statistics. There's a ton of other children out there that need home. And I know that not everyone here will foster. Not everyone will foster. But what you have done for us, keep doing. If that's all it is, if it's coming around other people going foster, keep doing that. It's amazing.
But I just want to thank y'all so much. Like, at one point, there was a time that she was actually going to be put in another foster home. And it was y'all that we kept her. Like, it truly was y'all. Just like sitting on the floor and crying, you know, or just being hugged in the driveway. We have her because of y'all. Group picture.
Yeah, just a couple things. We're going to take a big group picture. So everybody come up here. We're going to take a picture. And then everyone go back out there and eat all the cups. Laura Crawford made some amazing cupcakes for all of us. She made them, so definitely eat all the cupcakes. They're awesome. The gym is open for more than just just kids. If adults want to go in there and play, feel free to play. But yeah, have fun. Stay as long as you want. Make sure. Everybody come up here for a picture. Sorry to see you by myself.